Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, and welcome to Face to Face Behind the Scenes. The show which gives you exclusive access to the MTA team, production, and the judges and the producers. We're going to have a quick talk to see what they have to say before the live show. Last week we caught up with the judges just after the live show, but this week we thought, why not talk to the presenters and the judges just before the show to see exactly what it's like to prepare for the face-to-face live show. Assalamu alaikum. So Qasid, I thought this time we'll catch up with you before the show started. And of course, I'm going to come back to you in a minute. The judges, of course, last week I saw that some people felt that some of the judges might have been a little bit harsh. And of course, you know, that's up to debate, but it's...
I want to know which judge.
So it can be tough for a contestant, like you said, Qasid, last week, that they can be very nervous.
Yes.
It can be very hard to be on the other side of the screen.
Yes, yes.
So judges, before you go into the live show, what would be your top tips for telling someone how to tackle nerves before they're about to speak on a public platform?
There's a prayer in the Holy Quran with reference to Prophet Moses, and when he went to Pharaoh, he prayed, "Rabbi shrahli sadri wa yassirli amri wahlul uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli," which means that, "Oh Allah, open my breast and remove the knot in my tongue and enable me to speak in the most fluent manner." So that's a prayer that can be offered before.
So I think the important thing is to make sure that you're well prepared. And that means practicing. So understanding what it is that you're going to say and making sure that you practice well enough to understand the subject makes it a whole lot easier when you're putting forward your point of view, because you know what you're going to say, you've understood the structure, and you're then able to deliver that fluently.
I think one useful thing is to really understand the subject that you've learned about. If you really understand it and you're really truly convinced by it, and you understand that everything I'm doing is based on the teachings of that promised Messiah who is supposed to be for the whole world, and we have the key, we have that possession of that knowledge, and we have to spread it, then maybe instead of nerves, you'll get passion, which is good. And those nerves will turn into something that this is a great zeal on my part to want to convey this to everybody. So I feel if you truly go down, understand everything, and that will give you a passion, and that might help to calm some of the nerves down.
So Qasid, of course, last week, it's been a week since last week's show. You must have got some sort of feedback about the show. What did the public have to say?
Well, we've got great feedback. We've had great feedback in the past week. We've received messages from different sorts of people. We've received messages from young children saying there should be a platform for Atfal and Nasirat as well. We've received messages from women as well saying that, you know, such a platform should be there for the Lajna-e Maila as well. So, you know, it just all goes to show that this competition is really, it's a sought-after sort of platform. Everyone wants to participate. One thing I should clarify is that Majlis Qudam al-Ahmadiyya, the reason why, and obviously I'll sort of speak about this on the show as well, that Majlis Qudam al-Ahmadiyya, why we're tackling that or addressing the Qudam first is because the initial purpose of Majlis Qudam al-Ahmadiyya was for the youth and the male youth to be at the forefront in answering such allegations and questions. And at the get-go of Qudam al-Ahmadiyya, Hazrat Muslim Maud, the second Khalifa, it was his desire for the youth of the community to sort of answer these questions. That's why we felt that face-to-face would be a great platform for Qudam.
So are we saying that maybe in the future we might have a face-to-face for maybe youngsters, maybe even the Lajna-e Maila? What do you say? Is it too early to say?
Yeah, let's just leave it at that. I mean, you know what? It's going to be, look, I've said that now on MTA. So we are hopeful for that in the future. So let's see, you know, inshallah, okay. God willing, we may just have that.
Okay, Zagla.
So I'm mainly in the control room and I need to communicate with the presenter, who is Qasid Muin Sahib, to let him know what's going on in the background. Because as you know, we have five contestants. So we need to contact them, we need to call them, we need to see if they're available. Sometimes we have some mishaps that the line isn't clear, the line's not going through. So there's these things that can happen during the show. So we have to think in advance of what can go wrong and what we should keep in mind, that if this happens, then we need something as a backup. So.